So just to define, it is a cessation of breathing in a preterm neonate for more than 20 seconds, or it can be for a shorter duration if it's associated with bradycardia or desaturation. So this is what we are learning right from our initial days. And bradycardia in a premature infant is considered significant when the heart rate slows by at least 30 beats per minute. Most of the monitors are set at an alarm limit of 100 beats per minute, so that can be taken as a reasonable cutoff so you don't overdiagnose the problem. And the saturation level less than 85%, again, the alarm limits vary between units, and we want the saturation targets of 88 or 89 to 95% in most of the units. So the alarm limits may be a little lower than that. So this would fit with the alarm limits in most of the units. 86 to 88 is what most people keep. The target is different from the alarm limit as well. So if your alarm goes off for either of these two reasons, it's most likely related to apnea. So the lower the gestation, the higher the incidence, and the more likely it is to need treatment. We can assume that all babies who are extreme premature, less than or equal to 28 weeks, were diagnosed with apnea during their course. This is just physiology for them to be having physiologic apnea. And 85% of infants born at 30 weeks gestation, and then when it comes to 34 weeks, about 20% may still have. Obviously, the more premature they are, the longer it continues, the more mature they are, like the 34 weekers, you may not have a pronounced problem. You monitor them for 3-4 days, and if they are well, they can go home.